In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how we can control a DC motor using L298N module with NodeMCU, D1 mini, ESP8266 over the Wi-Fi. We will going to have two buttons to increase the speed. The motor will speed up or we will slow it down. Very responsive. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. I've seen a lot of requests and demand for controlling DC motor, speed of DC motor over Wi-Fi with ESP8266. So I'm using this L298N module. I've written library for this, so it will make it very easy to control this. You have to watch the introduction to this module L298N with my library. The link will be below this video. Make sure to run and control a DC motor before coming to this code, so you should be able to control a DC motor with the code with this module. Once you're successful, then make sure to run a simple hello world with this module only without a motor, and once that is successful, if you have issue with that, I have separate video explaining how to get started. I have two version video. One is like 3 or 4 minutes, just show you immediately to connect and use this. The other video is full detail of NodeMCU, and also a separate video for D1 mini. So make sure to watch those video and make sure that you succeed with connecting it over the Wi-Fi. After that, then you can come here and combine both these codes, so you will be able to control the motor. I've created this interface with two push buttons here, or two switches. One is called faster. When you press it, it increases in increment of 10. And in the code, you can also change it, so you can go in increment of 5. And also, you can set the minimum, because some motors at certain percent will not run. This is a percent of speed of motor, not the pulse modulation value. So don't worry, just put 0 means stop, 100 means 100% speed, because the library will take care of the conversion. So you can set the minimum also in the code. Let's say your motor starts at 15%, so set minimum to 15, and when you press this, it will never go below that value. Right now it is zero, so it can go to zero. As you can see, this is adjustable according to the screen. If you have a smaller screen, like say a mobile phone, it will perfectly fit in the mobile phone as well. If you need a wiring diagram for this, the wiring diagram will be available as part of my Arduino course at Udemy. The link to my course is below this video. Let me now explain the wiring. I've connected this positive at this point. These two wires are my battery. The positive is connected here, the negative is connected here. These two wires, this go to my battery. And the voltage that I'm connecting for the battery determines by this motor. If the motor is 12 volts, connect 12 volts. If it is 24 volts, connect 24 volts. It will work with up to 35 volts. And I have a separate video explaining that, so I'm not gonna go through that. Then from the negative at this point, this is connected to the negative of this module, or the negative of this module to the ground. So you have to connect it to the ground. You must connect, otherwise it will not work. If you're connecting it via USB, that's fine. If you remove it from USB, then you can use this 5 volts here. This will give you 5 volts out. Let's say you enter here, you connect 6 volts up to 35 volts. In any case, you will get always 5 volts here, and this 5 volts can feed to this module. Both of these have VU, so you can connect external power via VN from this, but you can connect VN. Let me show you first the voltage, 5 volts of this. I have separate video explaining how to connect the voltage of different pins. The link will be below this video. This motor is connected to this point. This is motor one. If you're connecting motor two, it will be here. So this code is for motor one. This is the enable pin. Enable pin is connected to D8. This is in one is connected to seven, and in two is connected to pin six. And if you're using this, exactly the same way as D8, D7, D6. Same way, if you're using this type of D1 mini, again we have D8, D7, D6. Accordingly, this will be connected to D8, D7 and D6. Need explanation of the code, this will be available as part of my course at Udemy, because it takes a lot of time, and I have step by step I will explain everything that you need to know about this code and the HTML page, so you can control the motor and also be able to customize it. The link to my Arduino course is below this video. Explain quickly the connection of the code. In one, in two, in three, these are the pin. I've defined them here as mapping, so you don't worry whatever is written on the module, you just type it here. D6, D7, D8, this is the enable pin, and these are the values internally used. Here is the important one, that you set it either CW, you just type CW, capital CW or capital CCW direction. And because we are connecting it to motor one, this is one. This is displaying the debugging. You have to watch my introduction video to the motor. If you don't want the debugging, all those text information, just remove it like this. This is the URL, the name that you want to access. This is what you type on the browser before even getting the IP. So this will make it very easy. And this 5 is the step of increment. Every time you press this button, it goes in increment of 5. If you put here 20, every time you press it, it goes in increment of 20. Output value, this 40 is initial value. If you want the motor to run at certain, if you want it at 0, just type 0, and if you want it at 50, whatever, just set that and motor will start. Minimum is the minimum of the speed of motor where it starts running, and this file is needed. I will provide you. You just put it in the same folder as the motor file. For example, this is the DC motor and this is the file. Put it together in the same folder, and as you can see, and here, once you download and have it, it will just work fine. You don't worry about it. It's already there. Let me now demonstrate it. I've connected it now to this D1 mini. This is the same chip. The code will work absolutely with all. I'm going to demonstrate it with the other one. And here from the serial monitor, we see that this is IP address that where you can access our module. And here, if we come here at the browser and we type that IP address 192.168.1 and then 100, you will see that we are getting this. But this, you need to know it every time that you run it. You have to check it here and make sure. Sometimes the DHCP server or your router will assign different IP and it will be bothering you. For that reason, we don't need to use that. So we will use the word here, whatever you type, that will be available. So in this case, Robojax ESP8266, I'm just copying it and let's type it here. And as you can see, it didn't work because I did not put http://, and then if I put that, now we can access that. This is a serial monitor that shows that the motor speed is at 40%. It also prints it here at 40%. And here I'm gonna speed this up. Now it says 50%, you see the bar graph at 50%. Now it's 100%. Now it's at 20%. I've set the minimum for this at 20%. The minimum speed is set here. If we want to set it at 0%, you can do so. So this is now at 40%. Let me refresh the page or reopen it. It's at 40%, as you can see. So if I speed it up, It speeds up 50%, slow it down 30%. Now I'm going down below 20. As you can see, I knew that at 20% this motor will stop, but we can go absolute zero. And now I've connected this NodeMCU. There are different versions. The number of pins are different, but the chip is exactly the same ESP8266, so do not worry. Even if you get this or a different version, all of them will work. Here, slow it down. Speed up, or maybe just keep it at 80%. Now it's continuously running at 80%. The direction of rotation is set in the code. It's in only one direction. And here is a demonstration of controlling it from the mobile phone. Very responsive. 100%. Now I'm going to change the step increment and make it 5, meaning that every time you press the steps in here, instead of 10, it will go 5. Let me upload the code. Here is a demonstration of step of 5. I've changed it in code. Now if I increase this, you will see it will go in an increment of 5. I'm going 65, 70, 75, 80, as it shows here in the serial monitor. Let me press it continuously. Zero, and the motor is totally stopped now. As you can see, at 10% it's not rotating. 15, 20 barely moves, 25 starts rotating. So you can go inside the code and perhaps change it. Here is the minimum. If you change it, let's say to 20%, it will never go below that 20. Library is loaded and we are connected. Now we got connected, so if I increase this 40, you see the jump because the previous value was there. Initial value that you set in the code was 40. And here is a demonstration that I have clockwise, counterclockwise buttons, and also start and stop. If I press the start, the motor will start rotating. Stop it, it will stop. If I start the motor, I can do the direction, change the direction to clockwise, counterclockwise, and also this will be available. And here is a demonstration of it using a mobile phone. I'm in the same Wi-Fi network as this one. Stop it, start it, change the direction, speed it up, the explanation and code of a video for this will be available as part of my Arduino course at udemy.com. The link will be below. Also, this will be available for people who are my Patreon at Patreon account. The link for my Patreon is available below. Thank you for watching. This was how to control the DC motor using ESP8266 over the Wi-Fi with L298N module. If you like this video and learned something, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe. Look at this one. Stop it. Start it, change the direction, speed it up.